Hey, good morning from Los Angeles, the Digital Marketing Center here in the South Bay. I'm your host, Jan Rognerud. And hey, listen, before I start today, actually today, very exciting presentation here. We're going to learn a lot. But before I start today, our agency is now opening up for some new clients. We typically don't do this too often. We're basically a boutique agency that deals with Facebook advertising, Google advertising, YouTube advertising. And we basically have waived our setup fees right now. So if you'd like to check us out, just go to chaosmap.com. That's chaos.com. And you can fill out a form there to speak to us, and we'll be happy to see what scenarios you are facing and what you might be struggling with and how we might be able to help. And if you want us to take care of all the business that you don't want to take care of, then just go to chaosmap.com. Now, this is exciting today. As I mentioned, we're going to be talking about how to get leads into your organization, whether it's a local business or a professional services business, and for instance, a financial services firm, right? So one of the things that you are facing out there in good old business slash internet marketing land is the ability to get leads, and leads coming to you that you don't have to chase, right? So no cold calling. And you want this to be explosive. You want it to be consistent. You want it to be predictable, and be able to essentially put your team on it to follow up on all these leads that are coming in. So today I'm going to share with you a very powerful model that we're using here to scale this up for your business. Now, if you're a small business and you're just looking for a few hundred leads, that's fine. But this one here, I'm talking about thousands of leads per day that you can scale up to be a fairly large enterprise for you. So without further ado, let's break right into it. And I'm showing you part of a screen here because, let's see here, I might have to actually, yeah, no, that's fine. We don't need to see that other part there. Yeah, this is part of a, let's see here, I can actually scroll this up a little bit. Yeah, here we go. So basically what I'm saying here is we want this to be a funnel for you that is consistent, as I said, and that can bring in a lot of leads into the organization. We're going to use Facebook advertising here as the example going in with traffic, sort of the starting point here. But the diagram that you're looking at, I'm going to take you through that right now. I'm going to go through this with you. But essentially what this diagram is outlining is a workflow and a structure for how you would set this up. And as I've shown here at the very bottom of the right side of the screen here, I put funnel segments as stage one, if you can see that down here. Let me see, I'm mousing over it. If you are coming in on Media and Marketing Podcast, feel free to see this show live on the Chaos Map live stream on Facebook and also on YouTube. But essentially down here at the bottom, I've put funnel segments, stage one. So there's several stages to this as you scale up. But when you're first starting out, we talk about top of funnel, middle of funnel, bottom of funnel. That's what TOF, MOF, and BOF stands for. And essentially what you want to do is you want to have a scheme here of allocation of funds for your paid media. So typically when you're first starting out, you want to put more of the dollars on the top end. So top of funnel stuff, right? So if you're pushing this out to a standard landing page, which we're going to talk about today, then you want to put a larger budget out the gate on the top, right? Now, the middle of funnel, and this could really be equated to sort of cold, warm, and hot traffic. So top of funnel, this is going to be the hardest traffic to get, not necessarily to get, but to convert, because they don't know you. They don't know, like, or trust you. You hear me talking about this a lot. Well, that is going to be something you have to work on, right? So you allocate more budget spend. So I'm calling this out as 60% right now. Well, middle of funnel, you want that to be sort of continually updating with audiences and with traffic that builds social proof, etc. 20% allocation right there. Bottom of funnel, 20%. As I said, stage one out the gate, this is an allocation that you could use. Now, some of these numbers are going to vary for you. You may have a higher risk tolerance here for this and want to allocate, you know, 80% top of funnel and then 10-10, that's fine. I'm just putting this out here in this model so that you can think about how do I best start out? How do I best allocate monies? And also understand that this is a customer journey. You know, for direct dials, we want folks to just come in and basically talk to our sales team and either, you know, in or out at that point, right? So the conversation moves along and it turns into a closed deal for you. That's great. But we know that, you know, a large chunk of these folks are going to just be tire kickers. They're going to call in and they're not going to do much, or they're going to go to the waste basket, right? Essentially what you're doing here is you're using the traditional funnel model, right? You're filtering out the ones that are not good and then building up the ones that are. Now, some of these folks are going to be quick on the trigger and be able to take action. Many are going to call in, find out more information about you, what your services are about, and or they're going to be on email lists, etc. So, you know, again, this notion of the customer journey is very prevalent and obvious in this sort of thing that we do online. But think about this in terms of the top, middle, and bottom of funnel, as I said, and allocations of funds within each. Now, before I continue, if you'd like help with any of this, just go to chaosmap.com. That's our agency. We're opening up for clients right now, and we're waiving our setup fee. We're doing this as a test right now, so feel welcome to head on over there. But let's dig in here. So the fact that you can really blow this up is awesome, but it's not necessarily a straight line. Nothing ever is, right? So what we want to do here is we're going to really just go through this model and then call out some of the potential gotchas and what you need to really focus on to blow this up big over time. And as I said, not everything is instant here, right? We want everything yesterday. I understand that. But this is also both a short-term and a long-term play. Short-term, as in you're going to get some quick wins in the door. Long-term, as in you have a business and you're growing and building over time. We want to see that do exactly that, success over time. So what we're saying here is we're getting clicks from Facebook. So essentially traffic is coming in and hopefully as targeted as possible. If you're brand new, you're going to have to season the environment, strengthen the environment through, you know, the natural building of pixels and data points to get this to be sort of a mature pool of data for you. But essentially what we're doing is we're just going out there and saying, hey, let's find the audience that is appropriate for us. So if you're in the financial field, well, then you want to segment that audience down, find them on Facebook, and drive traffic over to a landing page. Now, you could do it over to a standard Facebook page as well, but we're talking about a landing page right here, right now. So what we're doing is we're essentially clicking the ad on Facebook. We are coming down to a domain and a landing page, and we have an input form, and we also have a telephone number, an 800 right there. And you want to use the TEL colon link. It's a special link that essentially when people click on that link, it loads up your dialer immediately on your phone or even on your desktop, Skype, etc. Right? So you want to code up that link correctly. Now, once you have that, you have the opportunity for somebody to continue to the right here. It's a traditional sort of yes, no option here. And if they continue through, then they have obviously now filled out the form if they did that, if they didn't direct dial. And then you get to a thank you page. And the thank you page, if they're just sort of tire kickers at this point or early stage, top of funnel, you want to be able to present some information they can use. So this is often a guide or research paper or some information, the 10 things you didn't know about, you know, XYZ, right? And once they get through that, they land on a thank you page, which also has the telephone number 800, because they may be so inclined to dial at that point, right? And but it's not done yet. They may just have filled out their name and email. They have not dialed you yet, but we still are working on this in terms of the customer journey, because now they are stored in your CRM. So that means that you have the lead capture in the email name format. And now, as you can see in my diagram here, you have an opportunity to follow up. So day one email, day three, day seven, et cetera. And really, you can nurture this for a while. But if you're in a direct dial business, you don't want to sort of, you know, it's not too exciting to entertain the notion of, yeah, I'm going to close this client 30 days from now. However, this is like the snowball effect, right? As I mentioned before, you want to throw more money at this at the top of funnel initially, but all this underlying data is going to work for you from the pixels, which I'll explain here in a second, to all these email entry points or data entry points into your database. So all of this becomes valuable data. Now, one of the things that often can happen here is if this is not the highest quality or you've been able to vet this at some level, you might be able to sell this back out to a third party, which is not going to be a big revenue generator for you, but it is still in the revenue discussion, and it adds value to you as an organization as well. So that is kind of the simple workflow that I just described here, from the ad to the lander to the thank you to the email sequences that are built up here. Now the landing page, as I said, has that TEL on it. That TEL link, by the way, can be tracked at the analytics level. It can be tracked at the Facebook pixel level, so that you can build audiences from this. By the way, custom audiences is a powerful concept on Facebook and Google, and many platforms have this idea that you can build an audience based on behaviors that you can retarget to or remarket to, as Google calls it. The ability to essentially present advertising and follow them around on the internet. And now this is where it gets really exciting, because you can build up this massive volume of folks that you essentially quote unquote own, because you are now building these lists, right? So you can target the view of the page in terms of that custom audience. You can target the actual click here. You can target the folks who went to the thank you page. You can target you can even do exclusions, right? So you can build audiences of folks that came to the page and entered the thank you page and exclude the ones that actually came to the page, et cetera, et cetera. So there's many ways that you can sort of slice and dice this, if you will. But here's the important thing: the ability to do custom audience for retargeting through A/B testing, from videos to static images, is not only powerful, but it's a must do for you. And I put up here the various pixels that you should be adding to this massive opportunity for building back-end data. Obviously, anything Google that we want to put out here, Google Analytics, etc. We want to put the Facebook pixel out there, which is a JavaScript code. Most of these are JavaScript codes that go out there. Yahoo, Gemini, Outbrain, Taboola, etc., Twitter, LinkedIn, all of these really should be in what we call the Google Tag Manager. It's a container system for deployment of all these scripts. Well, then once you have placed all these, you're basically building audiences. And I had a speech on this down at the Chapman University in Southern California last week. I talked about always building audiences, ABA. Because these are essentially email lists that you're building, sort of a quiet or silent email list that you're building behind the scenes that you can retarget to. So you can segment the particular behaviors on these platforms, but you can also build these audiences on the different platforms. So if you want to do native advertising, then present that data on Taboola, for instance, and show up on the homepage of MSN Edge, right? That's an example. Well, then that's it. Now it gets very much into the omnipresence of your empire here, if you will, that you're building out online. So all of these things then become just a powerful mechanism for you to build audiences, but also present ads and then sequence those ads through this top of funnel, middle and bottom of funnel concept that I mentioned earlier. And again, as you start to mature this, just to get back to this funnel segmentation stage one for a moment, you're going to start to shift budgets now. You're not going to have 60% in the top of funnel. You can actually see more push towards the middle and the back end. And as you really mature this, and as these lists and email lists are being built up from the pixels to the actual, entries of name and emails, you will find that most of your sales, this may flip to a 80% back end, 10-10, right? Because you have so much data and so much opportunity to build lookalike audiences, which is really just another level of saying, hey, we got all these fantastic buyers and inquiries that are high quality. We want to get more of these. Well, let's build lookalike audiences. So for instance, for Facebook then, hey, Facebook, give us more of these people. through lookalike audiences. And lookalike audiences, if you're not familiar with it, has the ability to scale big. So you can go from a 1% up to a 10% based on these data sets. So very, very powerful. So stage two, stage three of your funnel segmentation will change. And by the way, this is the stuff we do at the agency, and we're opening up for new clients right now. We're waiving the setup fee, and you can go to chaosmap.com and check us out, and we'll take care of all of this for you and help you, and so you can focus on what you do best. Now, one of the things that really gets exciting here, so I talked about kind of the workflow here, talked about the funnel segmentation, we talked about allocation of budgets, we talked about, you know, building the audiences and retargeting and all of that. Well, it doesn't stop there. This is the cool thing, right? Now you can take it to the next level in terms of using certain technologies or tools that will really elevate this. And one of the things that we like to do, and we know this from just, you know, being available or sort of being a user of social media networks, is that when we see social proof elements, we tend to engage higher or better or more, right? And UseProof, I think it's useproof.com, essentially is a little script that goes on your page, your landing page, that shows potential other customers, you know, prospects that other people bought this. It's almost like the Amazon model of, if you bought this, then check this out, right? But this is actually a little slider pop-up that comes up at the bottom of your window, left side, right side. You can configure this a little bit that says, you know, Joe Smith from, you know, Manhattan Beach also bought this, you know, in the next or in the last hour or last 2 days, etc. A very cool use proof. Also, exit pops, right? Now, you got to be a little careful with exit pops. You got to check the advertiser policies, etc., because you don't want to, you know, have a pop-up that happens right when you land on the page. But this may be what we call an exit pop for you, where it says, wait, don't leave without getting this type of thing. It's a reminder, right? And I kind of mix this up in under the performance bucket here, but we use WordPress a lot. We design WordPress sites as well, but WordPress combined with Thrive Architect and gathering valuable data through pop-ups, et cetera, as I just described, using Sumo is a great combination to make sure that essentially not letting your visitor just leave by exiting the page or hitting the back button. You're basically popping up some information to help them and to track this. You also have the ability to put on a small script for a chatbot like Drift, right? So that is one of those things that we use on the site. Actually, we had one inquiry that just came in early this morning from a prominent doctor asking for help through the chatbot, right? So we're basically saying, what can we help you with today, right? Now you can be a little more specific than that to your particular segment of business and that landing page, but that can be customized. Push technology. So, you know, a lot of folks talk about email is dead. Well, push technology, like OneSignal for WordPress or subscribers, etc., is a small script also goes on your page that allows people to, you probably have seen them, you know, allow or block it. That's a little pop-up that comes up that allows you to essentially save that entry and then broadcast out later directly to their desktop, right? Push technology is huge. It's growing. It's used a lot in affiliate marketing, but essentially in business, this is a powerful technology that adds to the level of engagement and the opportunity for you to push out messages and broadcast almost like a messenger, right? I talked about the audience building here and the click events and the Tell 800. Google Analytics, mentioned that briefly. I mentioned Google Tag Manager. But if you really want to blow this up, and we all do, especially when we come to scaling on the interwebs, is to use Google Ads and the Display Network. That is just a huge, massive place for you to essentially be omnipresent, to be seen. You know, this is the concept of Bob, I see you everywhere. Janet, you are everywhere. I can't believe it. How does it all happen? Well, for a fairly small budget, maybe $10, $20, $30, $50 a day to start, build out your Google Display responsive ads and capture essentially on the wide web now the retargeted folks, the lists essentially that I talked about earlier, that you can then present data and information to. Very, very exciting. And this is where you're taking it to the next level. Now, what I wanted to summarize this with now to kind of wrap this up is to say that for your direct dials and really blowing it up, it starts with advertising, Facebook ads in this example, either to a direct dial from the ad or to a lander, and through that workflow that I just described. I am excited today, man. Can't barely talk. So that workflow, and then building the back end, and then switching the segmentation, or sort of the stages here from the top of funnel to more of the back end and the bottom of funnel, and then expanding out to a large universe with Google Ads Display Network. And of course, you want to consider YouTube as well here. Very, very powerful to add to. So you have just a lot of technologies and systems interacting with each other here. There's a number of sort of complex pieces, or more complex, I should say, that you may not be familiar with or comfortable with. If that is the case, I welcome you to step on over to chaosmap.com. Just click on over there. We can talk about this and how this would apply for you. But if you want to really blow up your direct dial business and understand how this works, not only from sort of the top line metrics and what you can expect, but also building out these systems for the long-term success of your organization, then feel free. Always enjoy making these for you. Always enjoy getting the questions and the feedback from these presentations. And I go live here every day, and I push this out to YouTube, as you can see it there, Facebook Live, and also on good old media and marketing broadcasts. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this today. And there's a lot of learning here, but there's a lot of cool things you can start with. And starting simple is always one of my mantras. And I look forward to speaking to you then. So without anything else here, I don't see any questions yet. But hey, thanks a lot for attending today. And keep doing what you're doing. All right. Later.